Today is 19th of November 2019, and this is Rappelz News.
I'm telling you, please move! This is how we fix problems!
And after a few hours of expert work from the WebZEN technicians, the servers have been brought back up online, together with the Halloween NPC. Now let's jump to the leaderboards. Mike, take us there.
Hi mate, by the way, I just want to thank you all for the opportunity. So, if we look at the leaderboards right now, one of the things we notice is that Fate is coming really strong in the top 10, while they do not have the first place just yet. And that's right now I have to give to Sojin, basically because he's guildless, and that's a very hard thing to accomplish. But Fate has 6 of their players on the top 10. And I have to say, it's a big mix down right now. You have everything from Void Mages to Marksmen, Slayers and Mercenaries. So, it is very hard to say what's gonna happen next week. And it's basically because, if you really think about, the EXP event's still going on. And if Fate keeps fighting the way they are, we may see a big change next week. And who knows, Momba may be in first place next. So, I think it's early for us to say what's gonna happen, but I have faith in Fate.
Thank you, Mike. And now with our sponsors. At BND, we love games and entertainment. And we are here trying to do the best for our listeners. So, hey guys, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, the bell notification sign, and give us a thumbs up so we can keep doing those videos. And now, back to the news.
Breaking news! Rappelz has elected Rakai as their new GM, and he has been quiet until today.
Mr. Rakai, so what is the role of a GM on an MMO?
That's a very broad question. As a GM, or nowadays CM, you have tasks like QA testing for new content and fixes, event planning and execution, interacting with the community itself, being the face of the company but also the contact point between players and devs, writing news and announcements on the website and social media, giving game support through tickets, and many other things.
As you know, Nazgul was one of the best known GMs of the game. How are you planning to fill up his role?
I don't think I can fill Nazgul's shoes, at least not at the near future. His passion for the game and knowledge of the game can generally only be achieved by someone who has worked with the game and community and also played the game for many years. I will do my best to be approachable by the community to hear your concerns and resolve issues, granted that the solution must be in the realm of possibility.
And how do you feel about this new assignment?
I'm optimistic. It's always daunting to come into an old and well-established community, especially with only base knowledge of the game. It means a lot of extra work in the beginning. However, so far the community has been very friendly and open towards me, which makes my job easier, and I'm grateful for that.
Alright, so there's a big divide on the whole class balancing. What are the biggest issues that the developers are trying to address?
I have to leave this question unanswered for now. I'm too new to the project to be able to make an educated statement on what has been done and is being done. Perhaps we can come back to this a later date. My professional but not Rappelz specific answer. Balancing is a near impossible task in any game. Even offline single player RPGs suffer from this. However, it is a goal that should be pursued and revisited frequently in MMOs.
What should be players expecting for the next month, and are there any new things that they should expect for next year?
There's not much I can am allowed to spoil. We have more holidays left this year, which we'll be observing the game, but that's probably not really news for you. I'm sorry if this answer is disappointing, but there are positive things happening in the background, which you will find out soon enough.
Alright, so last question. Is there anything you would like to share with the community?
As I said before, I look forward to working with all of you. Players of older games usually have a certain passion that is amazing to work with. I do hope you can have some patience with me while I learn more in-depth content of the game. And please, feel free to contact me on Discord whenever I'm online. And thank you.
And now, let's take a look in our forums. So Mike, what's the issues you want to address this week?
Alright mate, so I want to address two issues that people have been debating for a while. One has to do with about content, and the other one is the Hector Shredder version 2. So, about content, what we have to look at is the drop table, the path rework, and the leveling hole. And on Hector Shredder, we have to look at the class balance and the character switch. So, about contents, I'm sure a lot of people have been having this drop table, and it has to do with many things like the rupee amount and some items that some people just think they're garbage, you know. So, I guess what people want WebZen to do is take a hard look and things that are just worthless nowadays and try to rework them. Also, some of the pet cards that they can only get during events like Minotaurs and all. People would really like to be able to get those in some of the dungeons, even if that was on the new ones. Now, the pet rework's a different issue, and it has to do with older pets. Most of them, they're not used anymore. Some people just keep hold of them just for memory's sake, I guess. So, it would be nice if they could take a new look and maybe up the pets a bit. I mean, nowadays, for the most part, like, you know, new players, they can't afford the good pets, and the old pets just don't work. And the last issue about that is the leveling hole. And it's something I had issues with. And it's basically because after a certain level, it becomes almost impossible to go up. And I feel a lot of players they get stuck into it. And they rather just start a new character instead of keep leveling slow. I do understand that levels should not just be given to players. But when they only have one or two places to level, then it just becomes tiresome. You have to go a million times to the same dungeon to get one level. It becomes just too much. Now, well, the issue with Hector Shredder, it has more to do with the class balance issues. A lot of players get affected with class balance, and it's basically because they had a character that became weak or whatever, and now they have to change the character's weapon. And to change that, when you have a plus 25 weapon, it becomes almost impossible for you to sell. And since it was a class or a character that worked just fine before, they don't feel they should have to pay. But at the same time, I understand that those are things that the players ask to WebZen. So I really don't know a good answer for that. Maybe they could give something like one perfect weapon transfer scroll per account. I mean, there's not a right solution for that. But I think because a lot of players have been upset with the issue, it should be something to look into.
Alright Mike, thank you for your insight, and I would like to thank everybody who got to this point in our video. Thank you very much. Don't forget, subscribe, hit that notifications bell, give us a like, and leave a comment in the bottom of the video. Thank you very much, and we'll be seeing you guys next week for more Rappelz news.